Hello and welcome back to T Classified. Today we shall be having a look at question number 3A of WAEC June 2018, Christian Religious Studies. The question reads, give a detailed account of the death of Saul on Mount Gilboa. Give a detailed account of the death of Saul on Mount Gilboa. Alright, we shall recall that Saul actually offended God prior to his fighting with the Philistines, and there was a battle between the Israelites and the Philistines. This battle was so fierce that the Philistines were winning the war because God was already, you know, already turned his back against Saul due to his disobedience. So the Philistines fought the Israelites on Mount Gilboa and defeated the Israelites, which made the Israelites to flee from the Philistines. The Philistines overtook Saul and his sons, and they ended up killing his sons, that is Jonathan, Abinadab, and Machishua. But then they shot Saul and wounded him greatly, although he was able to escape some miles away from them, and he pleaded with his armor bearer to kill him so he wouldn't get killed by the uncircumcised Philistines. The armor bearer refused to do this as he was greatly afraid, and in return for that, Saul fell on his own sword and killed himself. After the armor bearer saw what has just happened, he drew his own sword and killed himself as well. Well, the news went abroad that Saul and his sons were already killed at the war front, so the Israelites ran away from their cities, which were later unoccupied by the Philistines, and the Philistines took the body of Saul. They cut off his head and took his armor and sent it to their temple, that is the temple of a god that is known as Ashtaroth, and just to show their victory over the Israelites, they strapped Saul's body and his sons to a place known as Bethshan, where they rejoiced and celebrated their defeat over Saul and Israel. At night, a set of people known as Jabesh Gilead, they took to bravery and they went there to remove the body of Saul and his sons to reduce the ridicule and the mockery over Israel, and they did that as a result of what Saul did for them earlier on, while he saved them from an enemy known as Nahash, who threatened to kill them. Nahash, the king of Ammonites. So that is the account of how Saul died along his three sons on Mount Gilboa. So let's take down the important things. So let's start with the fact that his death, Saul's death, was as a result of his disobedience to God's instructions. Okay, so he was at war with the Philistines, on Mount Gilboa. God was not with him. At the war, So the Philistines defeated Israel, and they fled. Saul and his sons were caught up with his three sons, killed by the Philistines while Saul urged his armor bearer to kill him so as to avoid being killed by the uncircumcised Philistines. Okay. The armor bearer refused, and Saul committed suicide by falling on his own sword. Okay. At seeing this, the armor bearer killed himself as well. The armor bearer killed himself as well. So after this was done, the reports went abroad that the Philistines already defeated the Israelites, and that they already killed Saul and his three sons. And that was how the Israelites fled their cities, and the Philistines came around to occupy them and made jest of the bodies of Saul and his three sons. So with this, we've been able to answer question number 3A of WAEC June 2018 Christian Religious Studies. I hope you like and understand the presentation. Do not forget to click on the like button, subscribe for more videos, and visit our website at www.educateafricans.com. You can as well get our CBT app on Google Play Store. It's called Educate Africans. Get it today and start practicing. Thank you very much, and God bless you.